Hello, Sophie here, and hand lettering. I hate it. I hate it so much. So it's fairly simple to add text to grease pencil artworks, but one of my favorite things about grease pencil is using the build modifier to have my pieces be drawn in like magic. And so I want to be able to use the build modifier to have the text be written in as well. My first attempt at this was a half success. Note that the second line is especially wonky and out of order, but I've learned a lot since then, and I would say that my newest piece is a full success. And so here's how I did it. At the top of the description box, you'll find a link to download for free both the blend files of this artwork as well as the file that I'll be working in today. If you're in a position where you can and would like to leave me a tip, that goes a long way towards helping me keep making free tutorials and content for YouTube. But financial or not, your support is so appreciated. And so today, I'll be using Blender, of course, as well as Krita to make the text because it's also free and open source. But if you have a different drawing software you prefer and it has a text function, definitely feel free to use that. So let's say I have this piece I've been working on. It's a 3D piece that the camera rotates around and it gets drawn in, because I'm a sucker for that. And I want to add just a bit of text to get drawn in alongside my 3D painting. By the way, I just recently discovered this new way of animating the camera, which has been so helpful. And so I'll also link that video down below because someone recommended it to me. And a million thank yous. So I tend to add the text as one of the last steps when I make my pieces, so I know how much space I have for the text. And so what I'll do is I'll find a point in the timeline where the image takes up the most space, so about here, and then I'll export it. But first, go into your output properties and just make sure that it's set to full size. I tend to keep this percentage value at around 25 to 50% while I'm working on my pieces so that I can do really quick and easy test renders. So we can press F12 to render a still frame and then save it. Now we'll open this up in Krita and then I'll use Krita's text function to add an incredibly deep and meaningful quote, something that really makes you think and reflect on your life. And we just want a pure black for the lettering. So I'm using custom fonts that my friend actually bought for me. I'll link them below, not sponsored or anything, but I am a sucker for fonts and paper textures. And it was like Christmas getting this, I love them. So when you turn a font into grease pencil, like how we're gonna do it, what happens is that Blender creates two materials, a fill for the letter itself, and then a holdout fill for the holes in the letters. Which is fine, I used it for this first piece, but I did run into trouble for this new piece. It didn't work well with the way that I had my background paper texture set up, and it actually made an empty hole in the animation. And also, I find it's not the most natural looking animation to have the letter be drawn in all black and then a hole magically appear. And so I prefer to get rid of the holes altogether to do kind of like those lettering stencils where there's the holes are broken up by lines. And so I'll duplicate my text layer, hide the first one, and then I'll convert this new layer into a paint layer. And then I'll just grab the brush tool, pick a brush that's fully opaque, and then you can either use the eraser tool or just the brush with a pure white color. You don't need to worry about maintaining transparency. We aren't going to be exporting this as a PNG. So I will just go through the lettering and open up all of the holes a tiny bit. Then when we're happy, we'll hide our grease pencil image and export it as a JPEG. And then we just want the background to be white. Now we can go back to our Blender file. And then you just want to be not looking through your camera when you do this. So then we can open up our files and just drag the JPEG into the scene. This created an empty with our image. And then what I find the easiest is to select it, go into object constraints, and add a copy rotation constraint, and set the target to the camera. Now, when we look through our camera, it's perfectly in line with it. So then I just want to roughly position it in space. I'll make my camera visible. And so I like to make it as close to the camera as possible, even going within the box of the camera. I basically want this image to be closer to the camera than any other grease pencil element in my scene. So then I'll look through my camera and just resize and reposition my image so that the borders of the image match up with the borders of my camera. And then you want to press Ctrl A to bring up the Apply menu and select Visual Transform. And then we can get rid of our object constraint. And it is perfectly in line with our camera, with our view, and in the exact position we want it. So then I'll select my empty, right click, and trace image to grease pencil. And then I always click OK before modifying the settings, because until I click OK, I can't see what those settings do. And then you can get a good idea of how the text is looking. So this is actually already shockingly good and close to the original text. It usually isn't this accurate right off the bat. And so the settings that I usually play around with are the thickness, the color threshold. I often have to get this as close to one without actually being one as possible. The sample, if I want a bit more stylized lettering, sometimes I bring this up, but not today. And the resolution. So something unfortunate is that if you click anywhere outside of this box, it disappears. And I don't think there's actually, turns out it's very simple to get that box back. If you go into Edit, and then Adjust Last Operation, or F9, apparently. And so I tend to just get the text good enough and then fix it up a bit more with the sculpt tools. And so I'll hide the image. I won't get rid of it. And at the end, I'll show you why it can be handy to keep it in your scene. Then I'll select my new grease pencil object, which you will name if you are an organized person. Oh, text. It's done. And go into sculpt mode. Shoot, these letters came out so nice. So I tend to just go manually letter by letter using either the push or the pull tools just to clean them up a bit. Sometimes, depending on the font you used and the size, they can lose their form quite a bit. And so I tend to fix them up just to make them a bit more readable. Something that I really like about this technique is that each letter becomes a bit different, both through the process of tracing the text and then sculpting them a little bit. And so even though we're using a font, there's still some variety in the letters, which I found really fun. And then if you want to close the gaps in your letters, you can go into Edit mode. Make sure you are in Vertex Select mode, which you can also access with the hotkey 1. And I'm gonna make sure I'm using the lasso tool. And then I can just go letter by letter and lasso select close to the edge of the gap on one side. Go back into sculpt mode. And I also want to turn on vertex select mode up here so that I'm only sculpting these selected vertices. And then I'll just close them up. So depending on how intensely you want to fix up your letters, this can take a bit of time. So for my big piece, I just put on a background YouTube video while I was doing this. It's like a tiny bit tedious, but for me, it's way less tedious than hand lettering. Maybe I'll keep these ones open. That's kind of cool. And then before we forget, slash I already forgot, we want to parent our text grease pencil object to our camera. And then if we go into the modifiers tab and add a build modifier. So now if we play back our animation, so that wasn't in order. And so to get these letters to draw in the correct order, we can do this in edit mode. Choose stroke select mode up here with the hotkey 2, and then select the first letter. We can use the shortcut M to move it to a new layer, which we'll create just for this. 2 for 2. And then I like to hide this new layer while I'm doing this step, just so that I know that as the letters disappear, that they have actually been moved to this new layer. And so I just do this one letter at a time, going in the order that I want them to be drawn in. And then we can delete this first layer, show our new layer. I'm going to open up my grease pencil timeline because I'm pretty sure the frame is at this frame because this is when I created the new layer. So I'll just nudge it back to the beginning of the animation with G. And then if we play it back, well, you can't say it's not interesting. I'm gonna be honest, using the script font like this was a bold choice, and of course it doesn't look very natural, but I think when I did it with a lot more of a simpler font, like for this piece, the effect, it was a lot more effective. But hey, I still think it's pretty cool. So now before we finish, 2 bonus tips. So you can very easily change the look of your lettering in the Materials Property tab. We don't use the holdout material because we've gotten rid of all of the holes. But with the stroke material, we can give both the fill and the strokes a different color. You could also go into vertex paint mode to create a bit of a multicolored watercolor look. And did you know that you can modify the fill and the stroke independently of one another? And so I can make a rainbow watercolor fill with a black outline. And then for the final tip, if you have multiple text elements and you want to add them separately, so for example, for this piece, I added each text block as its own new image and grease pencil object and traced them separately. So rather than having to go through the whole process of positioning the image every time in your scene, you can just select the empty, go into Object Data Properties, and change the image that it shows. So with this, you can add multiple text elements and they will all line up with one another. So that is it. I hope that this was helpful. I am very happy that I figured out how to do this because I think it's such a fun effect. So thank you for being here. I hope you have a great day. Take care. Bye.